dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rose through the cracks. Spotlight on you, behind you,
I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it go.
This for all the ones that doubted me. Gotta lose once to be a true winner. Only want the hundreds with the blues in them. Eating blood across it where the blood thinner. Juice stay turned like, you know. I've been through that water like Olympic swimmers. Only bread and butter what we ate for dinner. So I had to dream it till the dream is bigger. Only want the gold, we don't need the silver. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought, yeah.
I buy like 23. Won't fall again and I put that on me. Yeah. I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. Yeah. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, hey, champion, huh? Yeah, we here.
My goals, I do not feel ashamed. I'm a dog, I'm a beast, and I cannot be tamed. I don't do it for fame, it's the love for the game. I go in like I'm trained. I'm prepared for the rain, they amazed. I ain't break from the sticks and stones they threw. Anything that you could do, I could do it better than you. No matter what I do, achieve, still got something to prove. I spent the check on the diamond cross, but still ain't paid my dues. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought, yeah.
I buy like 23. Won't fall again and I put that on me, yeah. I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve, yeah. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, yeah, champion, huh? Yeah, we here.
Diving in this pool. ways. They say I'm the chosen one, see it in my face. Get this when I'm holding on, I can't be replaced. I just take a shift, but it's Brit. We on check for the win.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Toronto Mounties and the London Monarchs. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. Get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. And they'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. Play fake. Here's Love. And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. A bad start there. A big loss on their first play from scrimmage. It's second down. Seven. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Love from the gun, looking deep downfield. Almost able to intercept it. That's what he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. To throw again. Love. It's wearing the tight end with it. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Going back to Love. Possession defensively.
And you know the goal is to make something of a statement, especially on the road with your first defensive possession, isn't it? Go right out and establish yourselves and let them know this is going to be tough going all game long.
And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
Their own 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. First carry for DeAndre Swift. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Got him, the tight end, Hockenson. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. They run out of the gun with Swift. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. On third down, Stevens. Got his target, Samuel. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Good job, good job.
That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. On first and 10, it's Swift. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up second and four.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Inside the 25. 11 yards there. First down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
On first down, Swift. They'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
On second down, Swift. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. No score after 1 on EA Sports.
No score.
2nd down and 7. Now it's Swift. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. DeAndre Swift. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
He takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26.
At their own 26-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. He's going deep. He's got a man. Complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. And a huge huge play that time. 42 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Second down, Love. And the pressure gets to Love, and he'll go down.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the gun, Love. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. He would have kissed it on the ground.
Second down now, Swift. Now third down is looming, a pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. On third down, here comes Swift. First down as they get him to the ground at the 37. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the third down play. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll run here with Swift. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
On second down. Scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
From the gun on third down, Stevens, and that is incomplete.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. It's a 47-yard punt, but they did give up 10 on the return. And possession. formation will switch hands, first and 10. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time able to get three. That's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Love now on second down. Drop this off to his fullback. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
That's a task in the business, the coach. From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Throwing again, Love. And that is incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on, because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. This one brought in by the 6'5 tight end Waring. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Love, they go play action now. Dancing to his left. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Hollywood Brown, the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down.
Second and 10.
On play action, Love to throw. He'll buy some time right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, and it's third down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Tracy Walker, the 40-yard line. That's where the return stops.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
They'll run on first down. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of five.
Ball carrier.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Second down now. Swift. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play. And now third down gets tougher. Third and six.
And it's third down.
Throwing is Stevens. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. And that will wind up just short. He had it online. It ran out of gas
at the end, and this score will stay right where it is. Listen, now, no kick from 50-plus is a gimme, but here you're indoors in a dome. You'd think ideal conditions.
Yeah, it's one that he would expect himself to make, not just us expecting him to make it. Over the years, my theory is very simple. The athletic ability of kickers continues to get better and better. Check their background. They were all county, all state, and other positions, not just soccer players. These guys expect themselves to be great as well.
Falling on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Intended for number 24. Incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw again. Love. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And that is no good. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, as they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
this time?
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Once again, it's Swift. He takes this for 3 to the 29. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
A 7-yard return following a punt of 45 yards. Will come the offense as they take over. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all nothing offensively in this game. Yet, they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up the first down and keep the sticks moving.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. Play action this time with Love. Out to his left. Left side caught by Matthews. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Second and 5. Now a handoff here to his running back. Calling a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Off the play fake, Love. They'll roll him out right. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That one goes for 24 yards.
First and goal at the 3 yard line.
Love. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9 yard line. Now from the 9, here's second and goal.
Second and goal.
Off the play fake. Love rolling to his right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Sliding out of the pocket. It's caught. Touchdown. Kahale Wearing. The second touchdown on the season. And his guys have taken the lead.
I thought that was a nice job there, feeling the pressure and rolling out away from it and keeping the play alive. And I think he did it with the idea that his tight end would find his way free in the end zone, and his confidence was rewarded.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and the lead is now 10-7. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. A ton, do you, with a cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle?
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
11 yards there. First down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Same exact result as last play. A pickup of 11.
First down, Toronto.
First and 10, Stevens. That's going to be caught by Samuel. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
It's a gain of 5, brings up second and 5 at their 48-yard line.
From the gun, here's Swift. Nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Take him down.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
And it brings up third down.
To throw on third down, Stevens. escaping the pressure right, completes it to Samuel, and he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Welcome back now here in London. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Down Swift, and he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now. First down, and they go with Swift again. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On second down. Good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
They'll try and run here with Swift. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
Yeah, he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Off play action. Love on the move to his left. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Well, think of it like you would a typical boxing match. The person is on his heels and absorbing blows is having a tough time. That's what's happening to the defense right now, because the offense is on his toes and punching, and there's another first down run right there.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. I don't think anyone in the building fooled right there, as that one is going to blow up in their faces.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time, because let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Off the play fake. Love. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field have covered up essentially every blade of grass.
That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Now they try the right side here. And he'll only get this to the 14 as he'll come up well short of the first down. A good pickup there, 7 yards, but it brings up fourth down. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Dumps this off over the middle. A gain of 4 on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. A tackle almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Operating from the gun, Stevens. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to get the first down as he covers up after a pretty good shot there. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. He'll look to throw. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. Offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
At the 38-yard line.
He's back to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Well, look to throw. One complete, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The third down conversion successful, a gain of 11. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Running is Swift, and they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Now another timeout called for by the offense. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number 4.
Take this one back to the 37-yard line.
And that one? Oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41.
Taken down at the 40.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. As they run the counter play. And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Smiles for the folks here as they head for the exits. It's a victory for their hometown guys. And it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points, that lone field goal in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage.